politically sensitive and the media hyper. That is fine flow by Dr. V. Seshadri, a senior consultant physician from Sundara Medical Foundation. Sir, please consult.
I thank for inviting me. Actually, I am a member of IMA Amrita Ravati. Most of us from Sundara Medical Foundation, we are attached to Amrita Ravati. That's why I must thank Dr. Chandrasekhar for calling me. The thing is, as we said, it is politically bound, but the only one thing is, it's an alarm. The H1N1 is now and then crops up and creates an alarm in both for the doctor as well as for the patient. The worst thing is, now the period is where some of the students and everything are going abroad. So, last 3 weeks, we are flooded with asking for the anti-H1N1 vaccine to be inoculated. That's a story. Next slide. Yeah, the prevalence. See, this is the one, the latest prevalence. If you look on the right side, the Tamil Nadu also has shown a prevalence more towards the western side. But the number of cases so far for this season, the so-called influenza season starts from somewhere in November and then ends up in somewhere in April, has been around incidence of 3,000, and death is not that much very high. They have confirmed the death rate will be around 10. So actually we are having a second season. Next. Now, it is caused by a swine, the influenza virus. Commonly we have A and B. Now this is A. They are related to this in swine influenza lineage. Now, throughout the world, there is no difference in the type of the influenza lineage. That means the characteristics are same. So any vaccine prepared in one place can be used in another place. Okay? Now, this has a special target towards the pulmonary area, starting from the sinuses, the throat, as well as the swine. These are increased affinity, or most of the other organs involvement are secondary. So the level of pulmonary replication has been higher. The 2009 year is named because that is the time that everyone was woke up to this type of virus. So the H1N1 virus is named as 2009 H1N1 virus. Then let us interrupt. Now, we have always been in the paper and everywhere we are saying as the virus has gone into mutation, because this nowadays is not showing that amount of virulence. But no, there has not been a mutation of the virus has been noticed. Next. Now the epidemiology, for all practical purposes, it's an acute and self-limiting. The younger age group are more involved. Why the old people are spared is, probably they have been got exposure previously itself and have developed a sort of immunity. So that may be one of the reasons. The rate of illness in a group of population means approximately 10% of us can always get infected in an epidemic. The fatality rate is 0.5. Now in older people it is rare, but the fatality is much higher in older people and very young children, usually less than a year. Now, the relative contribution of the fomites has not been established. That means that if you try to share a room, the fomites do not play a part in spread of the infection, but the aerosol definitely has a role. Next slide. What are the immune? We don't know what is the type of immune response each one of us will have. The increased plasma level of interleukin, especially the interleukin 6, has been consistently found when the infection tends to be a very severity of type, in the sense that you need what is called a severe H1 infection. Definitely the interleukin 6 plays a very important role, and it has not been definitely told, but most likely if you measure the interleukin level 6, perhaps you can tell that these persons are likely to go into a severity phase. Now patients who died always had ARDS or acute respiratory distress syndrome, they have consistently the interleukin 6. So definitely the inflammatory markers do play a part in the perpetual of the infection as well as for the increased destruction. Next. Now what is the fascism? As I told you, it binds to the cellular receptors. These cellular receptors are present in the conjunctiva, distal airways and alveoli and pneumocytes. Nasopharyngeal lobe peaks. That means the moment you get infected, it is the nasopharynx which shows the maximum load, and that is acts like a small reservoir and then spreads into the lungs. The nasopharyngeal levels are increased even in patients. That means you continue to harbor the virus mostly in the nasopharynx and have an increased load, so that constantly it showers into the lungs and creates the destruction. Next. What is it? Basically, it's on. I think that the yellow line diseases. It is an extensive, no sites are spared, no low suspect. It's a diffuse alveolar damage with highly membranous and septal edema. And the, as I told you, the virus seems to target the alveolar lining cells. So that's why it's a primary lung failure which causes the death in these people. Next. Now, these are the things showing the destruction of the alveoli. The right one shows the presence of virus particles. Next. What are the basic clinical features? Next. The incubation period is as short as 1.5 days, and that may be around 3 days. They have found out that even after 7 days, the virus can stay and start replicating. So they have, in principle, it's a very, very acute illness of an incubation period of 1.5 to 3 days. Now, who are the risk groups? The increased risk of death is among the infected, especially third trimester. Watch out, pregnant people. The virus is easily amenable to you, and the severity is also high. And then, obese people tend to have a more severe illness. The presence of coexisting condition. Now, this has not been well defined, whether a diabetic or people with bronchial asthma, whether they tend to have higher or severity of infection has not been defined. But in a conglomeration, these people's recovery rate has been very slow. The delayed receptor. This is the most single important factor. That is the starting antivirus a little late. That has always led to the severity. In other words, early to start, early to recognize, and early to therapy is the only way the severity can be constrained. Next. Now, what is the, it can be afebrile, especially among the cause. The illness to an fulminant viral pneumonia. That is the other end of the spectrum. But the systemic systems are always frequent. It's a total inanition. One and a half, I tell you a case which I came across is one of the hospital workers. He's a cashier. He started having a little cough and sore throat, and by the night he developed high grade fever. He contacted me in the emergency room. So when I checked the throat, at the time the 2009 epidemic was already on, so he referred to him. Next day morning, you remember that the test was positive, and then as per government regulation, we have to shift him to the Pendelpet Isolation Hospital. So we shifted him. It took him nearly 3 weeks for him to come back to the situation. But the amount of we calculated what the government would have spent is approximately 3 lakhs. He was on a ventilator for 3 days. You remember that severity, rapidity in an end individual, if unattended, can lead to failure. So the systemic symptoms are in. One symptom which has not been well defined is the gastrointestinal symptoms. In younger individuals, gastrointestinal do occur, but in a classical case, gastrointestinal is not rare. So whenever we have a sore throat with a less gastrointestinal symptom, you can think of H1N1. The gastrointestinal symptoms do not predominate as a presenting symptom. The clinical symptom linked to emergency picture is a classical pneumonia-like picture. I think most of us are aware. If you have high grade fever, cough is less productive cough, and the X-ray is showing infiltrate, we are very sure that we are entering to be a severe pneumonia case. Next. I think the two elaborate sites, only one thing, what I told you, it is the third trimester of pregnancy, obesity, comorbidities, and delayed treatment. These are the most things. Next. Okay, well, once we know this, that is PRA, clinical suspicion, what ministry do is accounts. This is mainly to ensure that we had a coexistent bacterial infection, that elevation of toxic hepatitis phase is noticed. Now, one thing they have consistently stored is a raise in LDH. This is what they consistently told. If a poor prognosis associated with increasing level of other enzyme hormones, indicating that the liver is implicated, and thrombocytopenia, and of course, as the respiratory complications develop, they go into metabolic acidosis. Next. Now, what is the best way to get to know this? It's a must with clinical suspicion. Have a very high suspicion, please touch them for a test. Now, we have a designated center. What they do is the reverse transcriptase polymerase. It's called RT-PCR. Now, it is now done for the information. It is now run in high-tech labs, in the private sector, high-tech labs, then the listed labs, and then the Bharat Cancer Labs. They have been authorized by the government, and all medical colleges are ready. The best place to go at any time is the King's Institute. Now, the government does not charge any on this, because I like to tell you, the cost is now fixed at 3,000 rupees, it is fixed by the government in the private area. The test takes one day, because like previously that they just were testing the ELISA test, it has been given out. It is mandated that only this test is being used, and only this test is being done. No other test is being done. The visa, WHO regulation and enforced by the government, and also government of Tamil Nadu also does it. Okay. Now, the nearest lab has to be checked. Now, they collect samples at all times. It's a 24/7, all times, but your report will be ready by the next day only. Now, please remember this. Have a clinical suspicion and do it at the earliest. In fact, last Saturday I had a patient. Same, I had a clinical suspicion, so I sent it to the nearest lab, which is the high-tech. So the high-tech lab done, but the result was only available on Monday morning. Being a Sunday is intervened, they said the results and the process will be going on, but it has been checked only by the competent person on the next Thursday. So remember this. Now, why I am saying this, and we go through the slide, you will understand this. Suspicion, do the lab. Next. Now, the nasopharyngeal aspiration is mainly done. The no more nasal smear is never taken. If the nasopharyngeal aspiration are taken, swabs can be taken. They are immediately transported in a special medium. That is the rule. Now, the hospitalized to patients who is in a ventilator or things, the endobronchial secretions are also can be taken. They have a higher yield. Next. The repeated collections can also, in a suspicion case, you are not able to get, you are not very sure that the test is equal. Sometimes the test can be reported as equivocal. The lab is not always asked to redo the test. When they redo the test, the sampling is also done again. The viral culture is possibility, it's only an epidemiological thing. In India, the only one center where they do it is the viral research center in Pune. Next. Now, once we have done the labs, once we get a report, what is the management? Next. Now, antiviral therapy is the answer. The best proven now, cost effective, proven one is the standard term, Tamiflu, acetamiprid. Now, that is the best. I have added Zanamivir. It is also has come to India because the resistance patterns are being reported. So far in India, there is no resistance pattern reported. But you remember, nowadays the whole world is a one global village. So easy travel has been become much easier, and now the transmission is possible. So remember this, Astrazeneca Tamiflu is the one. Now, initially, this is the 2009, they found out that it is a resistant amantadine because it's cheap and it's easily available. So they found out on culture characteristics, they are resistant to amantadine. But one of the recent papers from China has told that combination of strontium and amantadine has been much more effective in clearing the virus. Okay, that's only a research news. For all purposes, oseltamivir or Tamiflu is the preferred choice and is the only preferred choice as of now. Next. Standard dose of Astramer can be used for treatment of mild illness. Of course, Zanamivir, I have told you. Early therapy reduces the duration of hospitalization and lessens the risk of progression to death. Yes, it has been established. Use of Tamiflu is definitely indicated and cost effective. Next. Because this antiviral therapy, no death has been reported even with people with all comorbidities, which I have listed. The course is similar in HIV patients also, and deaths have occurred despite early therapy because there is the administration of even after 48 hours they have admitted, but they have always resulted in some complications since the antiviral has generally reduced it. But after 48 hours also, please use Tamiflu, because I told you there are some patients where your results may not be available. Please, after 48 hours also, you can start Tamiflu. Next. Now, decision requirement should not await level. Please bear in mind, once you have clinical suspicions, you can send them for the test. Now, the Tamiflu does not alter your lab. That you have to keep in mind. Always we have a fear, like bacterial infections, we start antibiotic, the culture may not be positive. That is not so with this. Okay? Patient presenting progressive illness more than 48 hours after then should be treated, definitely empirically awaiting the lab. Please take the sample and then start the therapy. Now, if you are negative initially, if you are negative, but you have a strong gut. For example, in a cohort where one patient has been shown positive and the other people who have contact have developed symptoms, but their results are negative, they still treat. In other words, clinical suspicion, send for lab and start treatment. Next. Now, so what is the dosage? The dosage, the recommended dosage is 75 milligrams twice daily for 5 days. Now, pediatric patients, yes, there is a variation in the dosage, 2 milligrams, but for them also maximum is 75 milligrams. Now, less than 1 year, we do not have experience with Tamiflu. Less than 6, now they have reduced to 6 months. From 6 months onwards, you can treat. So, the birth to 6 months, we don't have any experience with H1N1, and so we have not used Tamiflu, so we are not known. So this, up to 6 months, we are not sure whether there is an incidence of H1N1, but cases have been reported in the NICU units that when there has been a contact, one of the nurses in China, she developed this and then she has spread it to the children. But for all practical purposes, less than 6 months, there is no indication for Tamiflu. The Tamiflu is not indicated for treatment of influenza in pediatric patients younger than 1 year. This is the old statement, now it is 6 months. Now, if you are suspecting a severe illness, especially by requiring intensive care therapy, you can step up the dose from 75 mg to 150 mg and the duration from 7 days to 10 days is also increased. Now, does a higher weight patient, that is the obese patient, also require a little higher unit, that's 150 mg, but 75 mg has been proven to be as effective as higher dosage in obese individuals. Now, if you are not able to swallow, you can give it through rice tube. The bioavailability doesn't get altered. Okay? Next. Now, what is the response? The early usage has induced a prompt clearance of the virus. The independent risk factors of prolonged delay are any age of less than 14 years. We don't know why male sex. An interval of more than 48 hours between the onset of symptoms and induction of therapy. In other words, delay in therapy can always land up. Next. Supportive care, all of us know, covering your nose. Antibiotic therapy has to be need-based. You have to prove the presence of bacterial infection. Then the IV immunoglobulin is investigational. Next. Zanamivir, I have told you, in resistant cases. Next. Now, Siddhas do not have any role. They are not, no established role. But if you have an acute ARDS, as the recommendation of ARDS treatment, Siddhas can use. Next. Prevention, cover your nose, wash your hands, then remain at home until you are able to play for minimum 24 hours of decompression. The vaccine, this is the most important part we know this. The vaccine is the, now there are many vaccines that are available in the market. Three vaccines have come, out of which only one is available now. The trade name is Vaxigrip by Sanofi. It has been approved by WHO as well as government of Tamil Nadu. About 10 years is one dose. And then 6 months to 9 years, we see, under the age, they take a longer time to develop the antibodies. So two doses are given, separated by 4 weeks or 1 month. The caution, if you have an allergic reaction, do not touch the vaccine. Next. Of course, these are the things I told you. This is available. This is the Sanofi vaccine indication. For 6 months, it is 0.25 ml. For more than 3 years, it is 0.1 ml. Most important, check the validity. Every 2 years, the vaccine will change because a new one will come depending on the US experiment. That is, the H1N1 characteristics are monitored in California, and every 2 years, new vaccine schedule comes. Do not use the older one. Next, the cost is about 610 rupees. The prophylaxis of contact is with, of course, Tamiflu. It is once daily. Treatment is twice daily. It is one daily for 10 days. Therapy should begin within 2 days of exposure. Of course, the duration of protection as long as you have the Tamiflu. The moment Tamiflu is stopped, your protection also stops. Next. Of course, the future directions are still, we don't know the exact clinical profile of the illness, who goes to where, we are still not very sure. But 2009 is only about 3 years we have an experience, and now only we are consolidating what is available from 2009. The single diagnostic, cheap, cost-effective diagnosis. See, remember, we have to pay 3,000 dollars to diagnose now. The antiviral therapy also is going through because the Tamiflu resistance has been started
coming
reported. Next. That's all. Thank you.
Any questions?
How did the Western countries brought it under control? Is it the universal immunization that they follow?
Yes, sir. The first year in 2009, they had this population only because of the supply was. Now the supply is very good. So they brought in, if I remember, what the report say in California, initially it was only 10% vaccinated in 2009. In 2010, they achieved 100%. Okay? In India, I'm quoting what is for Tamil Nadu. In 2009, we didn't have any much of vaccination, but in 2010, we are able to reach only 20%. And out of 20%, 70% are only in the urban areas. Now what the government is planning for even in the CHC level, if cases are reported, if the fancy of the thing is, since you started this thing, is 2 weeks before, Tamil Nadu government has instructed that all health workers, including doctors, should be vaccinated. I don't know now, 2 weeks later, that indication has not been enforced. I personally feel if you have what is called a doctor who is going to work in either an ENT area or in an area of say emergency where you come contacts all these things, because remember the rapidity of the illness that makes you sick, you will definitely, the people with H1N1, they will approach a doctor. I have seen this. As I reported to you, within 4 hours we are able to pick up, and the man has to stay for 2 weeks in the isolation. But one thing was, excellent care was given in isolation. It is beyond doubt. The man came back to us and explained what everything was done. The sheets are changed every shift. The disposable paper sheet changed. Each one had an exclusive bed pack and thing. And the consultant was visiting twice a day, and there was an assistant superintendent, a lady, I don't know her name, she almost stayed there for 3 months. And new blocks were constructed, everything we've changed.
Lakshmi. Lakshmi.
Yeah. She was the one who brought, not the enforcement, but she stayed there and ensured. I was very happy that thing. And more than that is, they also got involved in what is called showing and social activity. Because, see, if you remember, that is, once you are positive, whatever it may be, the richness, anything, you have to go there. So there was a totally a revolution among people where a social cause brought them together. And they all planted trees, then small plants, all these things as an physical activity.
Western countries, they did not isolate them. They were allowed to mix with their family members. And it did not spread. They brought it under control without any isolation.
No, that is not the truth. The truth is, in 2009, okay, more than Asia, it was the US which suffered. Total cases reported between 2009 and 2011, very rare, especially in the airports, you are screened. That's the truth. Now in India, we have not reached even a million. In Tamil Nadu, this time 1,000 cases were suspected, but only about 110 or something only proven, but there were 10 deaths. The last 27-4, the number of deaths is 10.
Sir, can you elaborate a little more on clinical suspicion? Because I am a pediatrician, I see 15 to 20 children every day with a URTI-like presentation, sore throat, fever, etc. The child who is progressing rapidly, who has a pneumonic presentation, I do the PCR screen. But how to pick out quite yet?
I will tell you, if you have an acute respiratory illness progressing fast, the only way you can confirm is the lab. Clinically, it is indistinguishable. That's why I put it as the first point of clinical suspicion. You suspect, do it. Nothing is lost.
How to suspect? Rapid progression.
It's only, see, the incubation period is within 3 days. The amount of the pneumonia they get is something initial. We have had in SMR, we have had 3 patients in 2010 beginning. All of them went into ventilator. They have to stay nearly for 2 months. Okay? And by the time they all came back, saying they are definitely left with their primary lung damage.
The lung is given antibiotic when it doesn't respond. Can we then think about what
is the lab? No. See, what I tell you is, this is the one thing we always see. Upper respiratory tract infection, do you want to give an antibiotic and not responding to antibiotic, you think of? No. The first thing is you do this and give Tamiflu. That is much better than giving antibiotic if you have a suspicion. If you have a suspect that you are suspecting H1N1, the drug of choice, I put it up. Do not wait for your lab report to come. Start. It's not like this.
But every case of the respiratory pneumonia, we cannot.
No, no. See, that is your suspicion. It's a rapid progression. I'll tell you. If you see a tonsillar enlargement or a lymph node enlargement, okay, and the progression is not that fast, it may take 2 days, 3 days, or 4 days. For the child, see, you can bend up. As I told you, they come up very fast to you within 1 day. Second day, they will come. I've had only 4 cases. I'm not a master of this. But the way it is, the total cases for this year is 0 for us. From January to as a date, I inquired my all my labs, everything. I had one suspicion. My colleague didn't have any suspicion. My ENT people didn't have. Before coming here, I inquired everything. Why I am saying is, nothing is lost. It's not the 3,000 rupees. It's not the coming through. But it's your suspicion that has to be on the high list. I tell you. And as he said, the person who sees more of URIs and things, please get vaccinated.
Sir, excuse me. Regarding vaccination, single dose is enough,
but
you need both the doses every year.
No, single dose. See, the only thing is the duration of the vaccine lasts is 2 years. That they found out. You can continue to have the antibody, but the problem is whether you have a protective level. That's why I told you in the future direction. You remember, we do not have a simple diagnostic test. We also doesn't know. The clinical profile is meaning is who is to go. star born, how long? See, all of us woke up only in 2009.
It's
available in intention and English.
And what's the dosage, right?
I don't know. I'm sorry. I have
Please use the mic. Everybody can hear.
2 drops in the morning, 2 drops in the evening.
For treatment, it's 5 milligrams. Each cup contains 5 milligrams. So you can give 5 milligrams, 2 cups morning and 2 cups in the evening. We are not using Dalamavir because of the resistance. Dalamavir is a problem. It can cause bronchoconstriction because it's a inhaled form.
Dalamavir, the one problem is...
And one more advantage of Dalamavir is
that it can be resistant with the
There is no reported resistance to other Dalamavir right now.
Virology research center. They are the authorities on what is the type of virus in India. They have not reported even a single case of that. Clinically also, nobody has reported failure of that.
We are seeing a lot of cases of H1N1 because we basically belong to ID there. So we are seeing a lot of cases of H1N1 right now. And any moment we got 4 cases or 5 cases there. But regarding the treatment guidelines, WHO treatment guidelines is safe there. So the person is adult populations. I am not talking about the pediatrics. It's very difficult for pediatric how to suspect. Other populations, anybody with influenza like illness, like fever, cough, sore throat or something there, you can think. But when to start also Dalamavir in the adult population is, you should see whether the person has got comorbid illness, or the person should be aged more than 65, or the person should be less than 5 years. Otherwise, any healthy persons, we just the flu-like illness, you take ordinary symptomatic management, only also Dalamavir when you start developing shortness of breath or something. In the category A, that is called. Category A, what is the advantage of using oseltamivir? We can reduce the symptoms by 1 day. On the other hand, if the person has got some comorbid illness or the person is sick, you can start him straight away oseltamivir because you can reduce the progression of illnesses. Category C, invalidity has been rightly pointed out, we should give high dose there. This is the recommendations for adults. For pediatrics, it's very difficult to suspect and very difficult to start. Better you can err on the side on over treatment rather than under treatment because we do not know the pediatric population there. That's one thing. Regarding the vaccine, again, these are the populations. Why healthcare workers are vaccinated? Not because they are more prone for severe disease. We want to preserve the health force to treat the population there. Most of the healthcare workers doesn't have any negative disease there. The healthcare workers belong to some underlying comorbid illness like sugar, uncontrolled sugar, CKD, or CLD, or something there. He's supposed to take vaccination. Otherwise, healthcare workers, no comorbid illness. Why we are vaccinating? To treat the patients, not because of the whole health.